of those categories. Yes? And then try to examine, analyze, evaluate and focus on all the four categories if I want to come to an ideal
conclusion.
Solution, option, conclusion, and that works. For this, I just want somebody, you know, actually taking some decision that you want to currently make, and then we can just see if it helps you to come to the best possible option. Can anyone think of? Yes, please.
Yeah, I want to find a... Actually, people might find this amusing, but actually, I want to find a bride for myself.
Good.
Very good. Wonderful. And that's a very important decision. So, you better do this. This is also known as, you know, cost-benefit analysis.
Yeah, I know.
And you better do that. Can we, like, in some time, let us know what are the short-term benefits that you would find beneficial if you get married?
So first of all, I think that this is a short-term benefits are that, to be very honest, that I have been deprived of the company of the opposite sex on account of not having a sibling. Going to a non-poet school, and for some reasons or the other, I've been at loggerheads with a lot of girls from the opposite sex. I've also been close and up at the same time I've been at loggerheads. But I think that intimacy that has been lacking. So I don't want to get into some kind of a relationship which is morally forbidden and which is a social taboo and which can invite legal problems. So might as well do something which is within the purview of law. So let me be very candid about it.
Intimacy, companionship, yes.
First.
Yes. Let's count it under short-term benefit, but I'm so sure that it can go into your long-term benefits as well. You know, we want relationships that last longer. Long-term companionship. Is that what you might be also looking out for?
Okay.
Are there any short-term losses that you think can, you know, come across if you get married?
Independence.
Yes, lack of independence. No independence.
No. Yeah, absolutely. My autonomy, I have to compromise on my autonomy. Secondly, maybe my priorities might get misplaced. I'll have to compromise on my priorities. Fourthly, the profession I'm in, you know, being a lawyer, you know how lawyers are perceived. Though lawyers are the ones who are at the forefront of getting freedom, but as of today, the nobility of the legal profession is on the decline. I don't want to get into the debate on that subject. But so, being a lawyer and being into independent practice and handling criminal matters, so maybe he may oppose certain decisions, but I don't get a lawyer bride. So, that conflict might arise.
Yes. So
and assuming it's an inter-caste marriage, the cultural differences that arise, the food habits.
Yes.
Third, as of now, I'm not earning a substantial amount. And if my wife turns out to be a spendthrift, then maybe it's difficult.
Losses are coming too easy. All right, but there are short-term losses. There are long-term benefits as well, and short-term benefits as well. But yes, a lot of adjustment.
Yes.
Yes, a lot of adjustment. The whole priority, you know, just changes. And I think these two things. Changes in your priorities and a lot of adjustment. Yes? Then what could be long-term benefits? I hope these also come quickly to you.
No, I think the long-term benefit is yes, that I could have offspring. That is the first thing. Secondly is that having a life partner where you could... You know, a life partner is not merely a life partner. It's a friend, it's a companion, it's a soulmate. Where you can share, she can stand by you in your hour of crisis, in your hour of need, she can give you emotional support, she can give you physical comfort, and fifthly, a lot of things.
Yeah. As I said, you know, the short-term benefits and the long-term benefits in this kind of a relationship are almost the same. So they definitely include a lot of companionship again, a lot of love, caring, you know, the affection. We are human beings. We need support. We need conducive environments to grow and to develop.
And
yes, yes.
There is long-term
spiritual
metaphysics.
On the path of actualization.
Metaphysics.
Yes. But yeah, no, up to your mind, that can also be your long-term benefit if you think so.
And therefore, or they say that, you know, though familiarity breeds contempt, distance lends enchantment. So, you know, she was able to understand the thought process, she was able to understand my wavelength, my vibes. Initially, there could be some mental incompatibility. Over a period of time, the adjustment, you're able to, the social adjustment is better. Initially, there could be some resistance, there is conflict, but over a period of time, that is resolved. As they say, life is the best teacher, time is the best teacher. You know, there is bound to be some only conflict. But we reach a common ground with maturity, with the evolution of the relationship.
And if you like challenges in life, I think you like
it. The hurdles are bound to be there. Hurdles are bound to be there.
Any long-term losses? Hmm? Any long-term losses?
No, I'm trying my level best to rule out the possibility of divorce, which is the irreparable loss. So, that is one irreparable loss. Sir.
Yes. But that would be actually your short-term benefit that moment. Getting divorced. I just want to get divorced. Long-term loss. How is that possible in marriage?
Actually, long-term loss in this case may be depending on some. There is no right or wrong. Because adjustment is one of the things we have to do. Now, somebody may say adjustment is also a loss. So, it all depends on your thinking.
Yes, definitely. Now, this table, you know, this is a standard format. Yeah? But the things that are included in each one of the categories for each individual is going to be totally different. So somebody's long-term benefit can at times be a loss for somebody else.
And see, ma'am, human nature is extremely complex, and there is no human manual that can govern human nature. So maybe the ego issues can be, ego clashes can occur, and the differences can be sometimes so difficult to resolve. You know, it can be unresolvable. Counselors have to come in. We need some mediator, someone to broker peace. So sometimes that ego clashes, you know, that can be a long-term loss. That ego clash is something. I myself handled matrimonial, you know, being a lawyer, domestic violence matters. I know how difficult it is to resolve. What petty, trivial issues, husband and wife want to drag each other to the court, and in the petition they make all kinds of allegations using intemperate language. I know to what extent each other goes, so I know. I have hands-on experience, so it's very difficult.
Yes, yes.
But that loss also
could
be a sort of a teaching also. Sometimes
yes.
It is beneficial also.
Correct. Here, according to him, as I see, long-term loss here is if the other person just doesn't understand me at all.
Yeah.
It is going to be a loss, for sure.
So the need of the R is amplitude. Amplitude is the need of the R.
Fact, yes.
Amplitude is the need of the
R. A long-term loss is your priority change. You have to sacrifice the self.
Again, adjustment, priorities
change.
And sometimes it can also lead to personality change.
Like in teenage, you have identity crisis, midlife crisis, middle age, you have midlife crisis.
Yes. And nowadays it is like teen crisis, midlife crisis. Each and every day is almost like a crisis. You know, every day your personality changes and yes, at that. But really, sometimes the adjustment can go to an extent where your lifestyle can change, your personality aspects can change. And then as sir said, it depends on how you think.
Because your personality change is also sometimes good.
Good. Yes. Do you want? Do you like the change in your personality?
How do you look at it?
Maybe sometimes, you know, youngsters are like very impulsive, indulging here and there. But after getting married, then they stabilize, you know. And then look into
become responsible.
That's a better change according to, yeah?
We hope for the best.
Yes. So here, now, can I do your name?
Shreyas.
Yes, Shreyas. You really need to think about your short-term benefits. You're looking for intimacy, your the companionship. Yeah, very good points. Short-term losses. Again, the adjustment. Yeah, sets in. So, is that adjustment really bad? Does the companionship is more beneficial than, you know, can you just overlook the little adjustment that it requires or a lot of adjustment that it requires?
And no, tremendous amount in my case because of my interests are concerned, because I have some unconventional interests. My involvement in politics is concerned, but I have a lot of academic interests in the profession I am in. And basically, I'm not the guy next door of a chocolate boy, because I have a lot of activities that I've been. Sometimes I become a workaholic or something. So maybe somebody who doesn't share my interest, or maybe somebody, some girl might not endorse what I'm doing. Maybe that can enrage me, irk me, and that can lead to squirmishes, squabbles, and altercation. So that's something which I need to be very careful with. So that for that, I want the other person to realize that these are my interests, these are my inclinations, these are my dispositions, these are my areas of interest. Kindly weigh the pros and cons of it, and if you are fine with it, then let's tie a knot. Otherwise, let's be clear that let's part ways. Otherwise, we can't have a relationship.
Yes,
let's be very clear about it. Things have to be crystal clear. There should be no gray areas. Yes. There have to be very clear about it.
As I can see, if you just actually think about what you want in life and what you want from your relationship, such thing can actually make it more clearer. It can clarify what exactly. Not only to you, maybe the other person as well. And you might benefit by letting the person know, by conveying to the other person.
See, I have to be forthright, I have to be honest, I have to be extremely candid. And firstly, I have to do great degree of introspection and self-audit. And I have to be extremely transparent, because this is what it is. And I expect transparency, I expect her to reciprocate with equal degree of transparency. And then things are fine. I mean, I don't want her to hide something, and either I want to be hypocritical about anything. I don't want that. The later something manifests which is hidden, then there is a problem.
Yeah. That actually, from where is this coming out? This is coming out from the short-term loss. He sees adjustment as a short-term loss. So adjustment, if anybody tells me to do it, I'm not going to do that. And all these things, must be like this, if you understand, if you agree to all this, only there. This all generally comes from the short-term loss of adjustment that you see.
I mean, I'm digressing from the subject, but in this country it is not a legal requirement, but in other countries there is this pre-nuptial agreement. It is not legal. That so if you violate, then it can be a ground for divorce. But in this country, they are opposite. So they make so-and-so things, and then they enter into agreement.
I guess we should have some more lawyers and
too many lawyers will never be here. Too many lawyers will always be in parliament.
Yeah, good one. Then taking into consideration long-term benefits and long-term losses, again, you have to focus on each one of them. Yeah? It is like, kindly give yourself a little exercise, whichever decision that you find please try this out. Write down whatever points that you can in each one of the categories and then analyze. How much important is the short-term benefit? How much important is the long-term benefit? No? Should I or should I not? It makes it more clear. If you focus only on the short-term benefits or only on the long-term benefits, then as I said earlier, you might actually become a little indulgent person in case of short-term benefit, like most of the addicts come from that. Or you can actually become a very same-like person who just keeps on compromising, maybe a doormat, like, whatever you say is okay, however you say is okay, the way you want to is okay. Then I'm not considering myself at all. No? know, I'm just considering somebody else's vision as more important, which should not ideally happen. Now, when I say ideally, rationality is in making an ideal situation, but the word ideal is very relative. And when I say relative, something ideal right now, at this moment, this day, this year, could not turn out to be ideal
tomorrow,
or the next year, or after 10 years, after the day. So ideal is a very relative term, and that is why when you're making a rational decision, your goal should be to take an ideal decision for that particular moment, for that day, the best, by analyzing all the four categories, not just focusing on one of them or just two of them. By analyzing all the four categories, then deciding the ideal situation, and also being ready for whatever the outcome is. Why is this important? This aspect you might not find on any Google search when you search for rational decision making. No, no way. I have personally added this. If in life you want to grow